Hello, everyone. Happy Thanksgiving. Welcome to St. Teresa of Calcutta Parish as we celebrate Mass on Thanksgiving Day. Celebrating with us today is Father Pigeon, and assisting him is Deacon Dave. For those of you watching from home, we will be participating in the Spiritual Communion hymn today. You can look for the words on the website located under the Spiritual Communion link. Our entrance hymn today is in the Breaking Bread book, if you have a copy with you. Number 199, Praise to the Lord. Number 199.
Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. Just want to let you know, if you have missalettes, the readings that we're using today are in the missalettes. They're in the front section of the missalette for this date. So if you just go to Christ the King, it's right after that. I'm afraid I'm going to forget, so I just want to make sure I tell you that if you want, there's a prayer for Thanksgiving cards in the back that you can pick up when you leave. And please, just in case we have visitors, just remember that we do ask that everybody receive on the hand, if at all possible. Should you not feel comfortable receiving on the hand, just make sure you're the last person to come up, okay? And then we'd be happy to give you communion. On the tongue. And also, I just, in case those who are watching on TV may not know me, since I'm not here on Saturday nights, particularly if you go to the Saturday night mass, I'm Father Pigeon and I'm in residence. And we're remembering in a special way in our liturgy, Leonard, Laura Sevich. And Terry, if you're watching, I certainly know who Leonard is. Just have trouble with that last name. So sisters and brothers, let's acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you fill the earth with your gifts from heaven. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are the Lord of the harvest. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed the hungry with every good gift. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us everlasting life. And let us pray. O God, who always listen mercifully to your servants in distress, we humbly beseech you, as we give thanks for your kindness, that free from all evil, we may constantly serve you in gladness through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Sirach. And now, bless the God of all, who has done wondrous things on earth, who fosters people's growth from their mother's womb and fashions them according to his will. May he grant you joy of heart and may peace abide among you. May his goodness towards us endure in Israel to deliver us in these days. Word of the Lord.
Alleluia.
For this is the will of God, for you in Christ Jesus. Alleluia.
From the Holy Gospel according to Luke. As Jesus continued his journey to Jerusalem, he traveled through Samaria and Galilee. As he was entering a village, 10 persons with leprosy met him. They stood at a distance from him, raised their voices, saying, "Jesus, Master, have pity on us." And when he saw them, he said, "Go show yourselves to the priests." And as they were going, they were cleansed. And one of them, realizing that he had been healed, returned, glorifying God in a loud voice. And he fell at the feet of Jesus and thanked him. He was a Samaritan. Jesus said in reply, "10 were cleansed, were they not? Where are the other 9? Has none but this foreigner returned to give thanks to God?" Then he said to him, "Stand up and go. Your faith has saved you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Once upon a time, there was a king and his personal assistant who went on a journey. And they encountered a lot of different weather situations. And, you know, when it was comfortably warm and blue sky, the assistant would say, "Oh, I'm just so thankful for this wonderful weather." But then it would get cold at night and he would say, "I'm just so grateful for this cold weather." And the king's kind of like rolling his eyes. And then they encountered a strong wind and the personal assistant goes, "I'm just so grateful for this strong wind." And the king's thinking, "We're freezing, how can you do that?" They encounter a heavy rainstorm and the personal assistant goes, "I am just so grateful for this rain." The king's really like, "You gotta be kidding." So one night they're building a fire. They had to camp out, can't travel in the night. So they had to cut wood, and the king was kind of a hands-on kind of king, and he helped his personal assistants to cut the wood. But in the process, he almost severed his thumb. And fortunately, his personal assistant was able to wrap it and help him with it. And so what does the personal assistant said? "I'm just so thankful that I had the opportunity to help you with this accident." Well, that was it. The king had it. He noticed that there was a ditch and he just couldn't take his personal assistant anymore, and he threw him in a ditch. That night, he slept, he got up, packed everything up, and left his personal assistant in the ditch. As the king is traveling on, he encounters a clan that is rather simple and superstitious, but overall nonviolent. And this clan does take him captive. And they bring him to their fortress. They had a wooden fence around their fortress. And when he comes in, they tie his hands and take the ties off his hands. And he's greeted by the leader. And the leader says to him, "O king, you are most welcome here. You are our honor guest. Because you are going to be the human sacrifice that we make one time a year to our God." The king's just, the blood just drained right out of him. "I'm going to be a human sacrifice?" They said, but we're going to eat. We're going to eat and celebrate because you are our honored guest. So they're sitting at the table and they're having delicious food and eating. And as they're eating, the leader sees that his thumb has been damaged. And he asked him about it and he told him how it happened. And so after the meal, the leader says to the king, you're free to go. The king just went, oof, you know, I'm free to go. But the king said, I got to ask you, I mean, I'm thankful, but I thought I was going to be the human sacrifice. And the leader said, oh no. We don't offer anything imperfect to our God. You are free to go. So as the king leaves there, he begins to kind of take a stock of his life, and he realizes that it was really horrible what he did to his personal assistant. So he goes back, and as he's walking back, he's thinking, I wonder if he'll ever forgive me. So he finds the pit, he addresses him and says, my buddy, I'm gonna get you out of this. And of course, the personal assistant said, I'm just so grateful that you came back for me. He pulls him out, and the king said, I gotta tell you the story. So he tells him the whole story about what happens, about, you know, being a human sacrifice, a possible human sacrifice, and how he was free because of his injury. And then he says to his personal assistant, can you ever forgive me for what I did to you? And the personal assistant said, forgive you? I'm thankful that you threw me in the pit. Now, the king is really annoyed. You're thankful that I threw you in a pit? He said, you bet I am, because if I was with you, I would have been the sacrifice. Actually, that wasn't a joke, but thank you anyway. There's a point to the story. The king is very much like the nine leopards who did not come back to give thanks to God. The king, he was clueless. Every blessing was in disguise for him. He didn't recognize what was being done for him in his life. And the assistant, his personal assistant, is very much like the leper who did come back. He was very aware of what was being done for him. In that story, the story does not mention God, and I decided, well, not the real God, not the God, or the God we worship, the one God, the true God. And I decided to leave it out as that story is told, because I think it makes a nice contrast with the gospel, that it reminds us that faith and gratitude and God go hand in hand. You know, you really can't have gratitude without faith, and you can't have faith without gratitude. Now, that intimately related. You know, faith enhances our gratitude, and gratitude deepens our faith. And so we have faith. We wouldn't be here today if we didn't. We wouldn't be watching this on TV. We have faith, and we have gratitude. But we want to make sure that we use it, you know, that we take time not to be like the king, not to be like the nine leopards, and make sure, you know, that we're giving thanks. Now, we get to do that every time we gather for Eucharist, because that's what the word Eucharist means, you know, to give thanks. So every Sunday we celebrate Thanksgiving. But also, an exercise I did when I was pastor at Epiphany, I like to get back to it because I kind of got away from it, was every day at noon, I couldn't do it at noon now because of my time in prison, but finding another time to do it, is I would sit in the presence of the Lord and say, what do I feel thankful for? And I would never do the shoulds. I refuse to do the shoulds because a spiritual director told me don't do shoulds. Oh, I should be thankful that I'm a priest, or I should be thankful for my health. It's just best to start with feelings, you know? So one day, I must have been having a really bad day as a pastor, and things must not have gone right. I could not think of one thing I felt thankful for. And that was valuable because it told me that I was having a bad day. You know, and I'm not sure that I was really aware of that. So I said, okay, I'm not giving thanks until I feel something. So I'm just sitting there and sitting there and sitting there. And then finally, it occurred to me, I really enjoyed the soup that I had at lunch. You know, and I'm not even a big soup guy. And I said, Lord, thank you for the soup. And then once that happened, the floodgates opened. And I was thankful for about 20 to 30 things I named to him. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. And what that did was it changed my attitude. I went from bad mood to good mood because my eyes were open to seeing the good. I was kind of like the king, you know? I was kind of like the nine lepers. I didn't realize so many good things happened in that morning. I just didn't see it. And so it's a valuable thing. And why don't we, I asked you to pray for me and you pray that we do that exercise, because it is a very, very valuable, it's a very valuable exercise to do in our lives. And what it does is it deepens our faith. So let's give praise and glory to the King. I don't mean the King in that story. He's not even real. I mean Christ the King. We celebrated Christ the King last Sunday. We come to the end of the church year. We want to make sure that we are like that one leopard who returned. We want to give praise, thanks, and glory to the true King of Kings, Jesus Christ. We call upon the Lord and offer him our petitions.
For all members of the church, may the love we share in Jesus Christ grant us comfort and peace of mind during these difficult times. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For local and national leaders, may God grant them compassion and wisdom in their decision making. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are sick or suffering, may the Lord place his healing hand upon them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our pastor, Father Paul Brandt, as he continues to recover from his successful surgery, that God will grant him strength and healing and restore him to good physical health. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our faith community on this Thanksgiving, may the Lord show us the many things for which we are grateful. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Judy Greff and Felix Cagliola Sr., may the Lord shine his face upon them and bring them to his eternal rest. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God, we can never thank you enough for your goodness. Give us the grace to always be aware of the many gifts that you give us. Give us the grace to resist the temptation to go to the shoulds. Please accept our prayers we offer you to Christ our Lord, and we say,
Amen.
Our hymn for the preparation of the gifts is number 559. Hymn of praise, number 559.
Hallelujah.
Christ, our brother, alleluia. To you the story of the Father's love, alleluia. With heart and hand and soul and voice, to you we raise this our hymn of endless praise, alleluia. To you, O breath of heaven, alleluia. To Spirit of unending grace, alleluia. With heart and hand and soul and voice, to you we raise this our hymn of endless praise, alleluia. Alleluia. To you, eternal dance of Trinity, alleluia. With heart and hand and soul and voice, to you we raise this our hymn of endless praise, alleluia.
My sisters and my brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty God.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, to praise and glory of his name, for our good and the cause
of the Church. O Lord, who gave us your Son to rescue us graciously from death and from every evil, accept, we pray, in mercy the sacrifice which we offer you in thanksgiving for our deliverance from distress, in Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For though you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift. Since our praises add nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. So, in company with choirs of angels, we praise you with joy as we proclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God,
for this is my body, which will be given up for you.
in a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And giving you thanks, he said, bless it. Gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of it, and drink it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which we put out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with the Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ, making each of us an eternal offering to you, so we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, to your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, whose constant intercession in your presence, we rely upon unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Nelson, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to prayers of this family whom you have summoned for you. In your compassion and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Leonard, whom you have called this world to yourself. Grant that Leonard, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body, to our departed brothers and sisters too, to all who would please to you at their passing in this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom, especially to Leonard. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all ages and praise you without end through Christ our Lord, to whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give to you. Look not on our sins, but the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will,
who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Jesus, I believe that you are truly present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to possess you within my soul. Since I am unable at this moment to receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as being already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
By the grace of God, come down from above and fill this Jesus, I truly believe you are present to me, and I thank you for your grace and your love. Come to come to
Let us pray. Almighty God, who through this bread of life are pleased to free your servants from the bond of sin, and in your compassion to restore their strength, grant us to advance without hindrance towards the hope of glory, through Christ our Lord. Amen. So I want to give you a money-back guarantee that if you do that prayer exercise where you only give thanks to God for what you feel, I guarantee you that you will get to what you need to be thankful for. You know, we do need to be thankful for our health, for our vocations, and for so many things. But the difference is this. If I start with shoulds, I'm going to stay in my head. If I start with my feelings, I'm going to get to my heart. And so it's going to be heartfelt rather than headfelt, should-felt. I know Father Grant wants me to thank you, to give thanks to you for just being great parishioners, and I want to join him in that. I'm sure Deacon Dave and all the deacons and deacon-to-be, Pete, want to give thanks for you, for your faith, for your witness, and we hope that you have a very happy and blessed Thanksgiving. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Our recessional hymn is number 200 in your Breaking Bread book. Now Thank We All Our God, number 200.
Now thank we all our God with hearts and hands and voices, who wondrous things hath done. In whom his world rejoices, who from our father's loins hath blessed us on our way with countless gifts of love, and still wills ours today. Oh, may this gracious God through all our life be near us, with ever joyful hearts and blessed peace to cheer us. Preserve us in his grace and guide us in distress, and free us from our sin till heaven we possess. All praise and thanks to God the Father now be given, the Son and Spirit blessed, who reigns in highest heaven. Eternal triune God, whose earth and heaven adore, for him it was, is now, and shall be evermore.
Everybody, happy Thanksgiving.